morning and welcome to Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV. I'm Kevin Ford. That's Captain Tommy Pellegrin. It is a foggy morning down here in Terrebonne Parish. Wintertime fishing, but with summertime patterns. Kind of strange what we're doing today. We've had some incredibly warm weather down here in South Louisiana for the last week or so. The water temperatures have raced up to like 65, 67 degrees. And Tommy, we're throwing shrimp imitation baits in the middle of January.
Yeah.
We'll show you why, and we're gonna catch some fish here today in DuLarge, Louisiana on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.
Boy, coming right at
it. Golly, you see their backs coming out the water. This is one of the most incredible sights you'll ever see. These fish are coming out the water. They're right here. There's about 1,000 of them.
That's the way to do it now. That's the way to do it.
Oh, he's got one behind him. There he is. This is absolutely something that you see videos of and you don't believe it. But look at it. You can look at them in the waves. There's just tons of them.
Oh, a shark. A shark ate him. That's the way to do it now. That's the way to do it. Hey, is this South Louisiana fishing or what?
Closed captioning is brought to you by Cypress Cove Marine and Lodge in Venice, Louisiana, where you'll experience world-class fishing. Visit us online at cypresscovevenice.com.
Ooh, nice fish, Tommy.
Yeah, that's right.
Coming out the water. Something you don't see very often this time of year, speckled trout dancing on top of the water, but that's exactly what we have right now, as we told you a couple minutes ago. It is wintertime, but the water temperature has warmed up. These fish are really active and they're feeding on these small baits, and sometimes you got to match the hatch, huh, buddy?
That's it. Match the hatch. Where's the shrimp? I don't know, but
this is a voodoo shrimp. That is a
Berkeley rattle shrimp.
Mine's actually a little bit smaller than yours, and I'm going to experiment with some colors. This bait right here, this rattle shrimp, has been the key, and this color has been the key. I've had some voodoo shrimp, so I'm going to see what's going on. But as you can see, to start off the morning, well, you didn't see me catch a couple of fish before the camera came on, but he's two to zip. So it's not going to take much longer.
Right.
For me to tie one of those rattle shrimp things.
We'll fix you up.
Yeah, we'll fix
you
up.
We'll fix you up.
Oh, nice fish
baby.
There, Tommy.
Oh, baby. Come on.
The rattle shrimp, kicking some tail. Out here. You have an extra one of those, by the way?
Nope.
How much you sell them for?
$5 a piece.
$5 a piece?
$5 a piece.
That's about a 16-inch trout right there. And we talk about times of year. That's a nice trout for this time of year.
I mean, yeah,
that's
not a really, bad.
Really nice fish. And talk about that rattle. What is it about that bait you think is so effective?
It's such a small rattle, you know, I can hardly hear it. I guess the fish can hear it, but it's a tough bait. This one's probably 3 or 4 trips into, you know, fishing. And if we can get, look at it real good, you'll see how tore up it is. And it's still hanging in there, but you're witnessing what's going on. I mean, this is January. There's no shrimp out in the marsh, but they're still eating it. Coastal candy color, Berkeley rattle shrimp. It's all you need right now. It's working really good. Hey, as soon as you got away from me.
You got another one?
Yeah. Come on, head shake me, baby. Head shake me.
All right, I think I am going to retie and get on a Berkeley rattle shrimp in just a minute. See, that's a nice fish. I'll tell you, one of the things you have fishing back here in the marsh like this, got a lot of wind in the wintertime. You're not gonna have that many calm days out here. And as you can see, we got about an 8 to 10 mile an hour wind blowing right now, but you get back here in all this marsh, it filters the water and you got clean water.
You got clean water, it's calmer in here. and you don't have to fight the wind as much as in the open bays, and you got nice trout like this. High knot waiting on you. Invite them to dinner.
See, that's the mistake I'm making. I'm casting into all the spots where you catch a fish. I have to go find my own territory. I'm having one of those mornings. I know your cork is about to go under right now.
Yeah, yeah.
Sometimes you're the bug and sometimes you're the windshield. Well, Tommy, as you're reeling in these fish, one thing you just told me that I did not realize, because I've never fished this spot before, is that you said you were too close to the grass. So we're fishing, obviously, a shoreline that's got some grass on it.
Yeah, there's a flat that comes out on that cove. There's a flat that comes out, got grass on it, and then it drops off where this current line is. And we're fishing where this falling tide's just starting to fall. It's coming out along that edge. And I pulled it off of that grass, and you saw it. I said, mm-hmm. Oh, I'm in the grass.
Yeah.
Pulled it off, popped once, bam, had a fish. You know, it's right there. They're right on the edges of the flats to the deep water.
And they're doing that right now because the water's warmed up so much.
They're actually confused. They're almost in their transition February, March. They're leaving the interior marshes, headed out. Where we were fishing 2 weeks ago is not far from here, but they're not there anymore. So what do? You think about, okay, if they're not there and they're headed out for their summertime, where do they pass? That's where you want to concentrate on. That's their route going out. And that's where we're finding these fish in these deep bayous and these along these edges, these flats, on their route going basically south. So that's kind of how we're finding these fish.
I have lived in South Louisiana all my life, and I believe in supporting the local businesses. And Donnie, there's nothing more local than Rouse's.
Thanks, Kevin. My grandfather opened our first store in Houma in 1960, and today we have over 50 stores in 3 states. We pride ourselves on selling local products, including wild-caught Louisiana seafood and homegrown produce.
So whether it's before our trip to get our snacks or after the trip to prepare the catch, it's always Rouse's, where it's the best quality, best prices, and everything local.
Booyah Clean Non-Acid Instant Hull Cleaner is designed to clean the dirtiest of hulls, removing water lines, scum lines, fish blood, and stains in a single application. Just spray it on, let it react, and rinse with water. It's that easy, and Booyah Clean Instant Hull Cleaner can be used on all surfaces, even carpets and decals, and is an EPA Safer Choice direct release cleaner with patent-pending chemistry. It's safe to use on water or land, and is endorsed by 3 of the legends in the fishing industry. Get yours at booyahclean.com.
Plaquemines Parish, just south of New Orleans, is the premier fishing destination in the country. From bass fishing in the Mississippi River Delta to redfish and speckled trout fishing along the coast, and to the best offshore fishery in North America, Plaquemines Parish has it all, along with waterfowl hunting and eco tours, several marinas, abundant lodging, great charter captains, and some of the best seafood in the world are reasons for you to come experience Plaquemines Parish, where it's not just fishing, it's catching. Visit us online at plaquemines.tourism.com.
With Farm Bureau Favorites, you're getting a great auto quote in 4 minutes or less, plus local agents and fast, friendly claims.
Great. Glad I went with Favorites.
No, it's Favorites.
Yeah. Farv.
Fave.
Farv.
Yeah, you know, fave. You know what? Doesn't matter. As long as you remember it's Farm Bureau.
Farv Bureau.
Yeah.
Get your 4-minute quote at Favorites.com today. Farm Bureau Insurance.
The best fishermen know that Venice, Louisiana is the place where you catch fish, and Lighthouse Lodge and Villas is located just minutes from Venice's marinas. Stay at Lighthouse Lodge and enjoy our brand new Bahamas-style rooms with all the comforts like satellite TV, Wi-Fi, refrigerators, and microwaves. Or stay in our condo-style villas and choose to have your own kitchen and room for the family. Either way, our staff is here to make your stay in Venice a great one. Escape to Sportsman's Paradise at Lighthouse Lodge and Villas.
There we go.
That's a better fish.
That's a good one.
And I put my cork just, I let it real still. Let the cork be real still, and this one just came up and whacked it.
Louisiana head shaker.
Yep.
And I'm all tangled up in it.
Oh, you are tangled up in me. And this is a mess.
Just reel it all up. I'm all tangled up in there. I got him.
You got him?
I got him.
Yeah, see, that's what happens when you get too close to my fish.
I was trying, that's right.
I mean, you know, once you get me started, I can't.
You can't stop.
No, it's just.
You can I only, try to knock him off.
I figured that's what you were trying to do. You gotta watch this guy, you never know. You never know what's gonna happen. This is gonna be a very interesting, oh my gosh, look at this.
Beautiful fish.
Beautiful fish. And this right here, ladies and gentlemen, this is a freaking nightmare. Fishy, fishy in the lake. Please come and take my bait. I'm not in the seaweed there, am I?
No, you got a fish.
I got a fish on. Yeah, I do have a fish on. You decided to move around a little bit, and that's another thing that happens out here this time of year is don't expect to stop in one spot and catch your limit. You're gonna have to move around a little bit, and Tommy just lifted up the power pole, and we just moved, and that's the result right there. Another
Louisiana
stuck trout.
Head shakers.
That's pretty good. But you gotta be, you just can't expect to sit and catch these fish one after the, I mean, you may, but look.
It's sometimes, yeah, sometimes, no. Now, we went 10 feet, you
know,
but there were a lot of littler ones right there. So I just eased over just a little bit. The further I was casting away, the bigger the fish were. So we're just gonna ease 30 feet over, get on these bigger ones, and it should be right.
And just keep on moving. And we're not gonna, we'll probably catch 7 or 8 and then have to move over again.
Yep.
That's a better one, huh?
That's a head shaker.
Good job, Tom. Tell you what's, people may be asking right now, all right, you guys are throwing the same bait. Why are y'all throwing the same bait? Why aren't y'all throwing some different baits out here? It's winter time. You're fishing with a cork. And there's a pretty good answer to the question. You've been fishing out here for several days and this has been one they're eating.
This is the only thing they're eating. Yesterday, I had one guy and he was throwing this and catching, you know, and as, you know, pretty much as a guide, I want to make sure that we're on the best bait there is. So I'm running through all kinds of baits. I caught one other fish on one other bait and that was it. Everything else was on the Berkeley rattle shrimp and it was beautiful fish. All nice.
And in this area, I was fishing Lake DeKalb, which is not real far from here, a couple of weeks ago. And we couldn't catch anything on a swim bait. It was all, we were catching everything on voodoo shrimp, those small baits. So,
yep.
Look, I have all kind of baits in the tackle box right now. I'm not about to do it. You threw them yesterday, I'm sticking with the rattle shrimp. But if you're wondering why,
yeah,
that's why. That's a big fish spot right there where I am.
I'm in the right zone, and I didn't get a big one. I'm at the move.
I'm
over
in the right zone, and I caught a big one.
And you got the good one.
Oh,
yeah, you
water.
Got the good one.
Yeah, I got a better one. Mine came jumping out the water. Look at him. This guy thinks it's May or June. Look at that, pretty trout, pretty water. You can't even see that rattle shrimp in his mouth. But that is an active fish for this time of year. Really an active fish. And Tommy, all right, we talked a little bit. We got the flat over here, okay?
Yeah.
So when we're off that flat, what are we in, five? What are we in right now, 5 feet of water?
5-6 feet right here. We're fishing in about 3-3.5, and it's about 1.5 feet on top of the grass flat.
Okay,
so that's right where it starts sloping off, getting down.
So it's we're fishing some pretty relatively shallow water. So
oh yeah,
I mean, so that definitely, if it was real cold out here, we'd be in another spot right now.
Yeah, if it was super cold, we would.
But
it
right
would
now,
be a little bit deeper water, and fishing very very slow without a cork.
Hey, before we hit our first fishing hole, our first stop is at a local Cracker Barrel convenience store. They have everything we need. Fuel, ice, drinks, snacks, and more, and even plenty of room at the pumps for your boat. With over 50 locations throughout Louisiana, there is sure to be a locally owned Cracker Barrel location near you. Cracker Barrel convenience stores, we have more than you expect.
Precision Tune Auto Care on South Sherwood in Baton Rouge is your one-stop automotive shop. From oil changes to major maintenance to new tires, our certified techs do it all. And we service diesels. Quality work at a fair price. Precision Tune Auto Care. Give us a chance to earn your business.
This is Don Dubuque asking you to join me as a member of the Coastal Conservation Association. For 30 years, CCA has worked in Louisiana to conserve our incredible fisheries, making sure that our fishing is great today and for generations to come. Whether looking out for redfish and specks, eliminating gill nets, building reefs across the coast, or work at the state capitol and in D.C., CCA is doing what's best for the fish and the sport we love so much. Your $30 membership will ensure that this work and our great fishing endures well into the future. Go to ccalouisiana.com and join CCA today.
If you're buying, building, or renovating a home or looking to refinance, the local mortgage professionals at GMFS can help. Interest rates are still at historic lows. In fact, if you have an interest rate of 4% or higher, call GMFS to see how much we can save you on your mortgage. GMFS has over 250 team members all working to give you the best customer service possible. For your mortgage needs, call GMFS at 225-214-5040 or go to gmfslending.com.
Hi folks, Roland Martin here. You know I fish for a living.
There's a bull red, 31 pound bull red.
Speckled sea trout, nice one too.
Oh my God, it's huge!
I got another one. Woo, woo! Bull red and kokanee, baby.
Come down here and do this for real.
Kokanee, just a few miles south of Houma, Louisiana. The limits are limitless. Hey, and the fishing possibilities are endless.
That's what Kokanee, Louisiana is about.
Miralure, the right tools to catch them.
There he is. Oh, baby. Oh, yeah.
Turn on the bite anytime. Tie on a Miralure.
How the Pros Do It is brought to you by Demco, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative. On our How the Pros Do It segment today, I'm going to show you the two newer VersaMax corks that we have out. This is the oval right here, and then this one you see right here is a hybrid cork between a standard popping cork and the oval. This is the hybrid. Really good cork. We've been using it a lot too. And again, if you haven't seen these corks yet, they're real easy. They all come with these beads and they come with the weight. And all you have to do is unscrew, put your weight in, and put as many beads in as you want. The more beads you make, the more noise it makes. Normally for speckled trout, we just put a weight in it and don't put beads. For redfish, they like a lot more noise, and we put the beads as well. But these VersaMax corks are outstanding corks. They're produced right here in Louisiana. The oval and the new hybrid, check them out, use them. You're gonna catch lots of fish.
I don't know. That's a head shaker.
Oh, I missed mine. You know, let me give you a tip about fishing. When you're fishing and the other guy catches a fish, look at your cork, because you're probably gonna hook one too. Oh, that's, yeah, that one's gonna be, boy, I better hold you up. That's a little bit bigger than what you've been catching, man.
Ha yeah.
I told you where to cast.
That's right. Good thing. Good
deal. Told you exactly where to cast.
Boy, you think they don't like to eat these things? Look at them way down in there. And you don't even hardly see that fish, that bait in there.
Now, Tommy, one thing about when you're shooting a TV show, it's fish after fish after fish. And we got 20 minutes of showtime to show you the fish. But this isn't a every cast sort of thing. I mean, it's a...
No.
Yesterday you fished with you and another guy.
Me and another fella.
You fished from about 7 o'clock to 11 o'clock. And it took 4 hours to get 50 fish. So when you're doing this, these fish are scattered. The water's warmed up a little bit. These fish scatter out a little bit. So don't think that this is like every single cast we're reeling in a fish. It's steady action, but it's certainly not fast and furious.
Right, it's not going, you know, especially working the bigger fish. I mean, we're catching some little ones, but the bigger fish like this is gonna be one every 5 minutes or so, but it's steady enough to just keep on plugging away, plugging away, plugging away at them, and you end up getting your box full and catching your fish. So don't give up if you just stop and catch one fish, and then you catch one fish a little later and catch one fish a little later. You sit there 2 hours, you're gonna catch a bunch of fish instead of running all over the place. So it's a good thing. Just kind of hang tight and crank them in.
Like this?
Yeah, that'll work. Look at it. See?
Hey, even a caveman can do it.
That's right.
Oh. Well, they eat these baits, though. You're right about that.
It applies. All right. Hold them tight.
Sorry about that, buddy.
Wait, let me reel this fish in.
Oh, wait, you got one too? Oh, you got a baby.
I got a baby grease popper.
You got, you back in, I'll tell you one thing, man, I got to get you away from kindergarten out here. You got, now it's a bigger fish, isn't it?
Well, yeah, you bigger fish.
Okay.
You don't think I'm catching one of your kind of fish.
Oh, you fooled me. I thought that was a little bitty. Boy, you just made a fool out of me. The way he acted small. He acted small. Oh, I missed one. Now, the other thing about this thing is, when we talked about a little while ago, is the color of the bait, which is, this is almost like an opening night. It's called Cajun Candy.
Coastal Candy.
Coastal Candy.
Coastal Candy.
And we'll get a close-up for you in a little while that you can see it, but that's been key, too. It's this color. It's not only been the type of bait, it's the color.
That color, that exact color. If you go buy the rattle shrimp, different colors don't work near what that one does right there.
And I would imagine if you can get any bait, if you found a voodoo shrimp that was exactly this color, I think it would work. If you found some of the other shrimp imitations, they would probably work. But I can tell you, this thing works. So if you go to the store, and look, they're not a sponsor of ours at all, but I'm sold on these baits, really good baits. Get you some.
Uh-huh, you bit it once too many times, you old head shaker.
Yeah, you missed him about five or six times, huh?
Not this one. This is a big one. I let the little ones go.
Oh, so that's, you have the skill that you can just let, like when the little ones hit, you know, and you just kind of shake them off.
I don't hook those. I just hook the big ones.
They always told me you were great on conservation.
Yep.
You know, I'm pretty damn good on conservation, too. I don't catch
them. Yeah, you just don't catch them.
Yeah. So it works both ways.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
13-14-inch trout.
Going good.
Beautiful morning. Sun's out right now. It's just hard to believe, Tommy, that we are in January.
I mean, right.
We've had so much warm weather in the last week. And before that, we had a freeze. And this weather's supposed to stay like this for another week or so. So we're going to have 2 weeks of temperatures that are in the upper 70s for highs. In fact, our morning lows are higher than what our afternoon highs should be for this time of the year. And these fish don't know what's going on.
That's why you go and you start fishing late February, March patterns, because that's the temperature we've been having for a week or two. So that's what the fish want to do when the temperature is that. You get out of where we normally fish when the water's 50 degrees. You know, water's 65, 67 degrees. So you start getting to where this is where they want to be with the water temperature, that temperature. So, you know, you got to adjust for what the conditions are giving you.
Plaquemines Parish, just south of New Orleans, is the premier fishing destination in the country. From bass fishing in the Mississippi River Delta to redfish and speckled trout fishing along the coast, into the best offshore fishery in North America, Plaquemines Parish has it all, along with waterfowl hunting and eco tours, several marinas, abundant lodging, great charter captains, and some of the best seafood in the world are reasons for you to come experience Plaquemines Parish, where it's not just fishing, it's catching. Visit us online at plaquemines.com.
For the best local seafood in South Louisiana, make sure to visit Salvo's in Belle Chasse. Boiled seafood, overstuffed po' boys, daily specials, and our famous all-you-can-eat dinners keep our customers coming back for more. Salvo's on Belle Chasse Highway, serving the best seafood for over 30 years.
Out of the swamps of South Louisiana comes one of the finest fishing destinations in the world, Cypress Cove Marina and Lodge in Venice. Our lodge offers 61 newly remodeled rooms with free Wi-Fi and a ship store with all of the supplies you need for a day on the water. Cypress Cove Marina also features a dry stack storage facility, 8 fuel pumps, a 3-lane back down launch, and fish cleaning station. From bass to blue marlin, come to Cypress Cove in Venice, where your dreams become a reality.
If you're buying, building, or renovating a home or looking to refinance, the local mortgage professionals at GMFS can help. Interest rates are still at historic lows. In fact, if you have an interest rate of 4% or higher, call GMFS to see how much we can save you on your mortgage. GMFS has over 250 team members all working to give you the best customer service possible. For your mortgage needs, call GMFS at 225-214-5040 or go to gmfslending.com.
MiraLure, the right tools to catch them.
There he is. Oh, baby. Oh, yeah.
Turn on the bite anytime. Tie on a MiraLure.
Nautic Star is making waves with their complete line of boats to fit your lifestyle. Our XTS series of bay boats leads the pack with extreme fishability, performance, and comfort. The Coastal and Legacy series are the perfect combo boats for fishing and fun. And the Nautic Star XS series of center console offshore boats blows the competition away with a smooth, dry ride. Visit our website at nauticstarboats.com to see videos of many of our models and to find a local dealer. At Nautic Star, we build a boat for you.
Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV is brought to you by Versamax, the ultimate popping cork system. I finally caught that sucker. Yeah, I finally caught that sucker.
And he could go in the box.
Yeah, you know, I thought it was a little bitty fish it was hitting, and he ain't the biggest one we ever caught in our lives, but 13 inches, 14 inches or so.
Yep.
But it's,
I gotta go.
I think I got him, buddy. I think I got this fish. The sun's come out, it's warmed up a little bit, and we're just continuing to work our way down this flat. And one thing I'm seeing out here, Tommy, right now, which is very encouraging, I see lots of little mullet.
Yes.
And so when you clean these fish, what are you seeing in them? I mean, what are these things eating right now?
I hadn't really paid attention. I had pogies the other day.
Yeah. So they're not eating shrimp for sure, because they're just not out here this time. So it's little bait fish that they're eating, but it's little shrimp imitations that they're hitting. Go figure.
Yeah.
Nice little trout.
The head shaker. He ain't a big head shaker, but he's a head shaker all the same.
Well, he's shaking his head down, isn't he?
Yeah. He don't like coming up.
Amazing though, every one of these fish has just swallowed that bait.
I mean, that's what's so good about that bait. I mean, they eat it, and very few ever come off on the side of the boat.
Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah, we haven't missed any of them on the side of the boat today.
When they hook it, it's hooked. You don't have a whole lot of choice. He's coming in the boat. Get big fish like that. That's pretty winter time.
There we go. Well, Tommy?
Uh-huh.
We've had a heck of a morning out here, haven't we, my friend?
It's been pretty good.
Yeah. Nothing like coming down here to DuLarge, Louisiana, in Terrebonne Parish, and catching a bunch of speckled trout. And about 8:30 in the morning, and time to go home. Great place to fish. Hey, it's January, y'all. We fish down here in Terrebonne Parish and DuLarge 12 months out the year, and here's the proof. Captain Tommy, thank you so much for a great day.
No problem.
And thank you for and more importantly, thank you for the secret bait.
Shh.
The secret bait, that's it right there. It's called the what? The
Berkeley Rattle Shrimp.
And the Coastal
Candy.
Coastal Candy color and Trout Candy right there. Hey, thanks for watching the show this week. Give Captain Tommy Pellegrin a call. He'll take you on a great fishing trip out here in Terrebonne Parish. And for producer Joey Bordelon, I'm Kevin Ford. We'll see you next time right here on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.